And we are back with some more Super Mario World Hacks 101. This stage is called Take Time. As long as it's called the name Take Time, I might as well take the time to say something that I don't think my commentary in the last video was as funny as it usually is. But I was just so in awe of how nice the hack looks. And I've played it before! It just looks so nice that I just had to compliment it about it a lot. But in this one, I will focus on the comedy. So yeah, as you can see, there's a whole load of mountainous and land formations. You see, this is actually how Mount Rushmore was designed. You know, it wasn't designed by a person, it was actually designed by nature. See, this is absolute proof of that, that you can see that all these things form some nice things. And yes, I'll get to that other text box. Design warning! Keys trigger the event after the normal exit. The same goes for secret goals. Yeah, when you select the exits in Lunar Magic, I don't know Lunar Magic that well. I believe if you put the secret exit second, it'll trigger the second event on the map. Make sure you use the triangle assist block. I don't know that one. I never tried the triangle blocks, which are probably what are showing in these hacks, in this hack right here. Is there anything over here? Yes, there is. No, my mushroom. No, mushy mushroom. Why must you taunt me? And will I be able to use this key without the springboard? I just thought of that right now, and I don't know if I'll be able to use it without the springboard. Usually, if you see a springboard and a key in the same level, it's gonna lead to where the key goes. But I guess we'll see. I'll think, yeah, it didn't lead me to it. So I guess I gotta go find the secret exit. Hold on a sec. Okay, I forgot to show the path that I unlocked leads to that level called Color Falls, but I'm just gonna go through the level again just to show how the heck to get to this secret exit. However I do it, it probably has to do with that springboard. Not gonna lie about that. I actually don't remember where the secret exit was, so I guess I will be finding that out soon enough. And why did I go up and get that dragon coin again? I don't know. They are not important to completing the game. And I forgot to hold the jump button. Yeah, if you wanna run across gaps like this, you have to hold the jump button, and then you'll be able to run across. It isn't like a normal Mario game in that regard, and I'm gonna get killed by a mole. I seen that platform up there, way back there. I wonder if that's where I needed to use that thing. I'm just gonna leave the springboard there and grab the key, and then run myself back over there. And woo! I hope I don't die. Okay. yeah, I bet you that's where the secret exit is over there. So I'm gonna go grab that springboard that I left over here and try to go up there. Hey, what the heck? See, I'm just not used to the controller yet. And I'm gonna... Yeah, I can just jump off here, jump on there, and grab that, go up there, and I bet you, yep, there it is. Yay! Next level, I could go to the secret level or take the main path. I'm pretty sure the secret level is actually just a dead end, so I'm just gonna do the secret level first. This one called Attention to Detail is so nice looking. Look at this, triangles in the wall. There's a really abstract looking background. Absolutely beautiful level design here. This area is kind of bland, actually, though. No offense, Tails, if you're watching this. But it's still, the walls look really nice there. Wait, red coin. They are worth 2 coins. Okay, so it's just like Super Mario 64 in the coin values. So that green coin that I got before was probably actually a blue coin. Yes, that is true. Water levels typically aren't interesting, so you definitely have to try your best to make them interesting. And this water level is about as interesting as you're gonna get with a water level. Well, at least when it comes to difficulty wise, and because, you know, the design is so nice. And yeah, if you make something that you can touch, like a really tight triangular area like those down there, if you make it so Mario can touch it, sometimes he'll squeeze himself through and get himself squished. So that can be a problem. Anyway, let's just continue with the level here. The actual main path there, that other way was just for power-ups and coins and stuff like that. Just look at this. It just like loops around each other and overlaps. That is just so awesome. Definitely, if you play this hack, take the time to smell the roses, so to speak. Ow. And not get yourself punctured by a spiky urchin. And yeah, just I just cannot believe this, and it's just so easy to tell where, you know, it doesn't interfere with the actual, you know, progression of the level. Like, usually when you get something that looks so crazy like this, it makes it look like that, oh, this is actually, you can go through here. But no, you can see that it actually overlaps underneath it. See that little corner detail there? It's just like stuff like that that make levels like this so worth playing because of the sheer amount of detail, I mean, the attention put into it. Ooh, flower, I could use that. Hey, out of my way. And yay. And what else do we have? Oh, look at this. It like loops over and under, just so nice. I just can't compliment this hack enough, and I said I wasn't going to compliment it anymore. Arrgh. And look at that. That's also awesome. There's just nothing more to say about this. It just looks so nice, and then the music is awesome. I've heard this song before, but I can't point... I just can't think of the game that it was in. If anyone can tell what the song is for, say so in the channel comments, then I'll put up an annotation or something on the video after it's made. And there's a Rip Band Fish, who I've turned into a fish fry, and another one, fire flowers and fireballs are definitely very useful underwater. Look at that, it's like a little ring around the rest of the design, and look at all these coins here in a nice formation here. I just gotta collect some of them just for the heck of it there. And through the pipe. And I'm sure this leads to the end, if I'm not mistaken. Ooh, we're like in Fall Town or something. It's like fall, autumn type colors. And that takes care of this level. And hold on, I gotta stop the recording for just a sec. And next level is... I just got a RAM save from that. I think I have time for one more level, and this is a yellow level, so it shouldn't be too long. This is called Color Faults. And... hey, Sonic Music, you are here and you are awesome. And I almost took a hit from that Koopa there. That would not have been pretty. And that was a dynamic jump, I gotta say there. Maybe I'm getting used to this controller pretty quickly. But I typically play like RPG Pokemon hacks on this thing, which is why I'm not used to playing Mario World hacks. Though I do play them occasionally, like this one, as you've seen. Ooh, message box! With enough effort, a hack can do things with palettes that seem either unlikely or impossible. It just takes some creativity. Yes, I did notice that myself, like when I make channel themes or... ooh! Or... take advantage of the palettes you have, trying to make the level design and colors work together. Yes, indeedy. Whoa, green stuff. Anyway, Charlie, why would you do that? Why would you throw a rock at me? As I was saying, while I was rudely interrupted by myself, when I make stuff like channel themes or YouTube layouts and stuff like that, whatever you want to call them, I always try to make the colors look really nice together. Maybe I'll make a purple and green theme like this. Nah, I'm just kidding. But this does look really nice here. And that does it for the level, I guess. That was really, really quick. But really, really beautiful. Also pretty nice to tip for beginners. Oh, bonus game! Bonus. I'm pretty sure this is the star. Yep, that's a star. Oh, no! No! Well, I guess I got two. Anyway. Bonus, as I was saying. And I guess that's about it for this part, so I'll see you guys later in the next part. So let's just see where this path takes us. It is clearing the forest. Mario is the greatest woodcutter in history. And looks like we're going into the lake. And another RAM save. Learned layer 3. Okay, see you guys later in the next part.